with music, Spotify. Hi, Ellie, playing, and even YouTube cut it. So that's unfortunate, but understandable. Okay, welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're going to get going as people kind of roll in on this gray Sunday morning. So we are supporting SWAN this week. The executive director of SWAN was supposed to be here today, but unfortunately something has come up and she couldn't make it. So I'm going to speak on what they do. I've printed out a little cheat sheet because they're a new organization to me and I'm really pumped that we can support them, especially given the tragedies, the murders that took place in Atlanta a couple weeks ago. So with that being said, SWAN, a local nonprofit, and they grew out of a pilot community healthcare project extending HIV/AIDS outreach to local massage parlors. And during that project, they recognized that women working in massage parlors were dealing with a host of issues that were much broader than sexual health. The concerns that were most important to women in massage parlors were issues related to law, immigration, and safety, among others. At the end of the project, they decided to continue working together. And in December 2002, which is almost 20 years ago, oh my goodness, the outreach workers formed the Sex Workers Action Network, SWAN. The name changed in 2008 to Supporting Women's Alternatives Network to ensure the inclusion of immigrant worker women who do sex work but do not identify as sex workers. So that's SWAN. They became a registered charity in 2017 and they do so much incredible work. It's all on their website. You can check it out. In terms of donations, if you're able to, if you'd like to donate this week, $25 supports health accompaniment and translation to a women's clinic. $50 supports one outreach shift to support women in their workplaces, and $200 to one woman through their COVID relief fund. So thank you for coming. As always, if a donation is not accessible for you this week, I'm so happy you're here anyways to sweat with us, this community. Okay, which has been going for officially 1 year today. It's been a year, we did it, we're still here. We're still going strong. Oh my goodness, okay. Here it is, Bootcamp to Benefit for SWAN, Vancouver, Burpee or Boogie Blast. Let me see. Ooh, Ellie and Carrie, would you like to do this today? Can you do the honors? Thumbs up, coolio. Okay, mother-daughter crew in the house. Let's get going, shall we? Did I miss anything? I feel like I've missed something. Have I missed anything? Maybe not. Okay. Lisa's here today to guide us through some chill mindfulness breath work at the end of class. So stick around for that. And we're going to get going starting on our bums today. I'll turn off the ding dong. And Sarah Lachlan, always so nice to see your name. Have a lie on your back. And get comfy. Find the most comfortable position you can. If that's not on your back, go on your side, go on your bum. And let's get right into our breath this morning. So if you need to wiggle side to side a little bit before you come into stillness, go for it to try and be as comfy as you can be. Maybe you need a pillow under your head or your knees. Take a big inhale collectively and a deep sigh, exhale it out. Maybe eyes close for this portion of the class to tune into the body. We go again, full inhale, so you cannot take in another sip of oxygen. Sigh it out, deep exhale. Keep breathing deeply, maybe noticing the bony outcrops of the back body against the earth below you. Noticing the bones, the joints, the muscles, the fascia, all the goodness of our beautiful bodies. One more big clearing inhale, fill, fill, fill. And exhale it out. Good. Bringing the hands to the abdominal region if it feels okay for you. Start to notice the rise and fall as we breathe in and out. Check into your shoulders now, or your brow or jaw, somewhere where you typically hold tension. And if you are holding tension there, can you kind of give it a wiggle, send the exhales to those spots to try to release that tension? And then as we exhale, we're going to start to add a little bit of voice, a shushing or a like you're blowing out a candle across the room. Noticing, hopefully as you do that, you start to engage deep within your abdominal area. So from your diaphragm all the way down to your pelvic floor, you start to feel an engagement, a contraction as you create that sound with the exhale. Go again, inhale, feel the belly rise, front sides. As you exhale, can you draw the sides of the waist towards the midline, draw the big bone and the rib cage towards the belly button, feeling that engagement. Last time here, inhale, find expansion, the chest, the rib cage, the belly. Exhale, draw the hips together, shush it out. Full, 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 exhale. Lovely. All right, let's add a little movement here. Start to windshield the knees side to side. Inhaling as they lower, exhaling with that shh to bring them back up to center. Maybe feeling how your core, your obliques work to make this small movement happen. If you feel a really lovely spot, stay there for a sec. Just hang out in the twist. Hands can still be on your body, or you can have placed them by your sides for a little kickstand, feeling into the ground. Awesome. Come back to center. Reach the arms overhead. Send the legs out. Straighten the legs. Take an inhale and reach long with the fingers and the toes. Exhale, hug your right and give it a big squeeze. Inhale, reach long. Exhale, left knee. Big squeeze. Alternating again. One more time each way. Oh, yeah. Other side. Lovely. Place both feet on the ground, bent hands come to the earth, push into the hands, push into the feet, lift the hips up into our glute bridge. This can be a little lift, it can be a full extension of your glute bridge. And let's start squeezing the bum. Not sure if your bum is actually contracting, take your hands, briefly place them on your tush, give them a little love tap and check that your bum is squeezed. Awesome. Hold here. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Let's lower the bum halfway down as we inhale and then exhale, connect into arms and feet, push it back up. Keep going. Come back to that shushing breath if you lost it. So as you exhale, you lift the hips, you initiate with the core engagement and lift up. Let's go for four more like this. Three, two, hold the top. Now we're just gonna go down an inch and up an inch, a little pulse. Inhale down, exhale lift. Inhale down, shh, shh, like that. Shh, for eight, seven, six, starting to feel the five, for four, for three, for two, for one. Hold the top. Now we're gonna pulse those knees out an inch and in an inch. Inhale, open, exhale, back to hip width. Go for it. This is a great position here if you want to bring the pelvic floor to the movement, which I always recommend. So feel the pelvic floor kind of open and expand as the knees open. And then as you exhale and bring the knees back to center, you lift perineum, lift rectum, and the core engages as well, or the abdominal core, I should say. Pelvic floor is part of your core. We go for three more, for two. Let's bring those two moves together. Down an inch, up an inch, open and close. Down, up, open, close. Hello, glutes. Yes. Let's go for four. Come back to the breath. Inhale down, exhale lift. Inhale open, exhale close. Three. Two. Oh, last one. Awesome. Slowly lower the bum down to the ground. Whew. Take an inhale. As you exhale, tabletop the left knee on top of the hip. Take an inhale here. Exhale, core engages, then lift that right knee on top of the hip. Hands come to your thighs. Take an inhale to lengthen the spine. Imagine the vertebrae getting a little bit further apart from one another. And then as you exhale, press your hands into your thighs back into your hands. Keep shoulders pulled down. Try not to tense them up. Inhale to release slightly. Exhale, push again. Keep going. Trying not to imprint your spine into the mat here. We want our neutral curvature in that lumbar spine. And we don't want to be tucking our pelvis as well. Just try to keep long with the spine. The only engagement you should feel really is in the core and a little bit of the arms pressing and chest pressing into the thighs. Oh, keep going. I know I'm shaking like crazy. 3, 2, and 1, reach the arms overhead, dead bug action as you, opposite arm and leg drop at the same time. You can keep the knee bent or you can extend it and then draw it back overhead. Keep going. I want that still knee to be on top of the still hip. So watch it start creeping in towards the chest. Try to keep it right on top of the hip. Love it. Keep going. Keep breathing, keep engaging the core as you exhale. Holy smokes. Let's go for 4 more. I'm sweating already. For 3, for 2, and 1. Hug the knee to your chest, maybe into a happy baby, maybe just a hug, do what feels good, maybe move side to side. When you're ready, flip it over, tabletop position. I went through fetal position. You can rock and roll. All right, come here into stillness in your tabletop, shoulders on wrists, hips right on top of knees, and do what feels good in your spine. So maybe you want a cat-cow, maybe you want a side-to-side wiggle or make some circles with the body. Feel free to close your eyes and tune in to give your spine a little TLC this morning. Wherever you are, can you draw your shoulders down away from your ears, soften your elbows? Lovely. Curl your toes under, downward dog. Take a big inhale here into the back body, the back of the legs, the glutes. Deep exhale, feel into the fingers, the heels of the hands, the toes, the balls of the feet. Go again. Inhale, find expansion, lengthen the neck, draw the shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, connect into the hands and feet. Take that right foot, lift it up to the sky, maybe bend the knee and open the hip for a hip opener if it feels good for you, and then shift the weight forward, bringing that right foot to the outside of the right hand. It might need help to get there. Let's drop that left knee, reach the right arm forward in front of you, and then rainbow, keep it overhead, looking back slightly towards the right side. Go again with the arm, reach forward, big inhale, reach with those fingers, find expansion and length. Last time, go for it, reach, inhale. Exhale, plant the hand down, send the leg back, same left, leg goes to the sky, maybe bend the knee and open the hip. Take a big inhale here. As you exhale, engage core, shift forward, left foot outside of left hand, float or drop that right knee, draw the shoulders down. When you're ready, if you're going there, reach forward and open, look back behind you. Third and final time. Love it. Plant the hand, send the leg back. Awesome. Okay, we're going to go here in our downward dog. Take a big inhale. As you exhale, take it back into a tabletop position. So the knees come under the hips. Inhale back to downward dog. Exhale, slow transition. So you're feeling the core start to really fire. Tap those knees down. Keep going. If you want to, you do not have to tap the knees down. You can just go into bear plank where your knees are floating an inch off the ground. Although I find it more challenging almost to tap the knees just like a little kiss on the ground. Each time you come forward, draw those shoulders down. Find as much length through the crown of the head as you can. We're here for 10 more seconds. Push into finger pads equally with the heels of the hands. Woo! 3, 2, Downward dog. Walk your feet to your hands, feet to hands, bending the knees as much as you need to. Meet me in your forward fold. Shake it out a little bit. Shoulders, wrists, head, neck. Awesome. Slowly rooting down through the feet. Rise up one vertebrae at a time. Awesome. Couple shoulder rolls. Go one way. Go the other way. All right, let's get into some legs. Squat it out for me here. Sit the booty back. Feet can point straight forward or slightly out, turn with the knees following suit. Inhale down, exhale, lift pelvic floor and engage as you rise. Four, three, two, and one. Step the right foot back behind you, like a couple inches. Now we're gonna do a deadlift beast dance style. So hinge the hips, send the booty back behind you like you're touching the wall behind you, super light on that right foot. Exhale, push into the left foot to rise. Warming up the glutes and hamstrings on that left side in particular. Keep going. Inhale, drive the bum back behind you. Exhale, engage core to stand. Your gaze follows you as you go down and it comes straight forward as you rise. One more time on this side. Awesome. Stay on that left leg. Bring the right leg out to the side and lower. Lift and lower. Try not to lean. Rather, engage the core and only lift the leg up as high as you can without the lean happening. Three, two. We'll see this move again. And one. Switch sides. Beast stance deadlift. Light on that left. Heavy on the right. When you're ready, inhale, hinge the hips, look down as you fold, exhale, push into right foot, rise, squeeze the bum at the top, inhale back, exhale, keep going, really push into the floor, push away from the floor as you stand, you're going to feel your glute and hamstring more when you do it that way, nice job, three, two, and one, hang it on that right leg, little bend in the knee, flex this left ankle as you lift, and lower, nice and tall. Exhale, lift, feeling that side booty working to abduct the leg. Four, three, two, and one. Good, little side to side tap here. We're gonna round out our warm up with a little cardio. Any arms you want, so you can jab like I am, you can jack the arms, you can forward punch, you can do anything you want. Maybe get a little lower, maybe go a little faster if you're feeling it. Let's go for eight, seven, for six, five, four, three, heel digs. Tap those heels forward, little bicep curl action with the arms. Maybe adding a little hop, maybe getting low and going fast. Let's go for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, straight back. Grab those cords overhead, pull them down. Or like you're digging those cross-country ski poles into the ground. Eight, seven, six, five, for four, three, two. Take a breather, grab some water. We're getting into it. All right. Today we have two moves. Strength for 45 seconds, cardio for 25 seconds, 15 second recovery, three times through. So your first move is gonna be a curtsy. So if you have a booty band at home, you wanna play around your thighs, go for it. You're gonna get more resistance for the glutes. If you've got weights, you wanna carry them, shoulders by your side, go for it. So you're gonna curtsy squat, stay low if you can, come to a squat, back to a curtsy other side, alternating sides each time. So it's just a squat, curtsy, squat, curtsy. That's your strength. Your cardio, double squats. You're gonna come down in a squat, do a little hop at the bottom or just come to tippy toes at the bottom and then stand at the top or hop at the top. So squat, little hop, big hop, little hop, big hop, or little tippy toes, big tippy toes. That's your cardio. Okay, that makes sense. Let's go for our curtsy in three, two, 45 seconds. Curtsy to squat, weights optional, booty band optional. Staying low, When you need a break, you can stand up in between. If you're cool to stay low, stay low, stay low, stay low. Beautiful. Sitting the bum back in that curtsy so the knee is landing on top of the shoelaces or the ankles. 18 seconds to go. Then more space. Yay! As you warm up, maybe you've got a little more depth in the curtsy and the squat. 4, 3, straight into it, down in a squat, either to tippy toes or a little hop, then stand to tippy toes or hop at the top. Little hop, big hop, nice soft landing. Try to make it smooth. So after the hop, you're just straight back into that squat. Whew! Yes, 8 seconds, then you get a break. Nice, Alana, I see your little head bopping up and down. 3, 2, rest. 15 seconds. That was round one. We're doing it 3 times. Oh boy. Breathe. Ready? 3, 2, let's go. Curtsy. Squat. Curtsy. Find your breath here. This is like big time active recovery. Still from that cardio. Maybe it's just me. Maybe that rest period wasn't enough. Whew. Yes. Good. Check that front leg in the curtsy. You want the knees and toes in the same direction. So they could be slightly angled or pointing forward, but try to get them going in the same direction. 10 seconds to go. How are the legs? Holy smokes. We are here for 4, 3, 2, let's do it, curl. Little to big. Try to push off those feet if you're going to heels or into your hop. Squeeze the bum at the top. If you're coming to a heel elevated here, squeeze the bum. Might as well. 8 seconds to go. Keep it up, keep it up. I'm with you. 3, 2, rest. Oh boy. Yes, yes, we get to do it one more time. 8 seconds, shake it out. Ready? 3, 2, curtsy. Let's go. Oh my goodness, my quads are really feeling this. Keep going. Last time you're doing this. So if you've got a couple more inches in your range of motion and you're feeling good, go for it. This is it. You got 20 seconds to go. Oh, maybe stay lower in that squat. Ah, oh goodness. There's that whining. I'm doing it again. Can't help myself. 8 seconds, then our final cardio push of this round. 4, 3, 2, let's go. Little, big. 25 seconds, you can do it. Dig deep, full break, coming up while I demo what's next. Yes, holy smokes. Almost there, push, 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 get higher, get lower. 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. Oh my goodness, so much quad, need water. Good job, team.
I feel like there's no good time for this, so I'm just gonna call it now. It's Bootcamp to Benefit for SWAN, Vancouver Burpee, and Boogie Blast.
You know the drill. 90 seconds. We're taking it back to, I don't know, the 50s or the 60s for today's blast. Rock.
Bushy blonde hairdo, surfing USA. You'll catch him surfing at now. Ventura County line, Santa Cruz and Trent, Australia's Caribbean, all over
USA.
We'll all be planning out a route we're gonna take real soon. We're waxing down our surfboard. We can't wait for June. We'll all be gone for the summer. We're on safari to stay. Tell the teacher we're serving USA.
Nice job. Woo. Okay, thanks, Carrie and Ellie. Grab some water. Fun song. Okay, moving on to a deadlift. Again, weights optional. Okay, one-legged deadlift is your strength. Can't breathe. So you're gonna come down here, oh goodness, in your hip hinge deadlift, your back toe can tap if you're wobbly like I seem to be, or you can extend, reaching to an I shape overhead. As you stand up, the knee drives in, you pull those cables, elbows graze the rib cage. Inhale, length, flex that back ankle. Exhale to stand. So if you've got the weights with you, they might be too heavy to overhead reach them. So just keep them down in front of your shoulders. Nice and close to that left front leg. Okay, cardio, either high knees, marching, jogging, or running. Or if you want to, mountain climb. In your plank position, you choose the tempo at which you climb. Those are your two moves, let's do it. Left leg forward, right leg back, 45 seconds. Timer is on, go. So that right leg is floating or resting on the ground. Reach the arms overhead. Square that right hip to the ground. Inhale and reach. Exhale, engage core. Push into left foot. Draw those elbows into the rib cage. Keep going. Trying to find as much length from that flexed heel, flexed ankle heel to the fingers. And then as you exhale and stand, connecting and feeling that fire, that engagement deep within, grazing the rib cage with the arms. Whew, as you pull in. 8 seconds to go. Mountain climber, high knees in 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. You can be standing, driving those knees up. You can be in your plank, shoulders on top of wrists. Whew. Shoulders pulled down, driving the knees in. 25 seconds of this, then we get a 15 break. Exhale as the knee pulls in. 3, 2, 1, rest. Oh boy, okay. 10 seconds and we're onto that right leg. Left leg going back. 3, 2, excuse me, let's go. Inhale to lengthen. My house smells like French toast, which is like a cruel, cruel thing you're doing to me right now. It's like cinnamon goodness. Awesome. Check into that left hip when you're in your deadlift. Is it opening to the left side? Can you square it down? Point the hip and the toes to the ground. 20 seconds to go still. Oh boy, you can always tap that left toe down. You don't need to keep it elevated. 5, 4, 3, 2, high knees or mountain climb, let's go. 25 second cardio push. Maybe you wanna cross the body a little bit with the knees. Get a little oblique love. Ah! Keep breathing. 3, 2, rest. Okay. Third round, I will cue you at halfway and we will switch legs. Starting with the left. 4, 3, two, let's go. 22 and a half seconds per side. Ooh. Keep going. You got about five more seconds on this side. Three, two, switch, other side. Right leg heavy, left leg lifting. Keep breathing. 12 more seconds on our final high knees or mountain climber. Nice job, team, I see you. Four, three, two, let's go. Last time you're doing this. Wherever you are, if you found some tension in those shoulders, pull them down. 10 seconds, go, 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 go. Five, four, three, two, rest. Okay. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Push-ups. No, not yet. We're not even there yet. So like we did in the warm-up, we're going to do a side lift. So some options. Have a booty band. Go for it. Heavier at ankles, so harder at ankles versus shins versus thighs because you have further to lift it. No booty band, no sweat. I'm not going to do it. So we'll be just lifting and lowering. You can lower all the way or you can just keep it up and pulse a few inches up and down. We'll switch. Third round, we'll alternate. Your cardio. Side step, tippy toes. Side step, tippy toes, or side hop, hop. Side hop, hop. Okay, more legs. Yay, three. Side lift, in two, and one. Left leg heavy, right leg lifting. You can be nice and tall here, or you can sit that bum back in a little baby squat. Checking that the knee's not going forward to get into the squat, but the bum is going back. Flex this ankle. How much strength and length can you get in that right leg? It can be a full lower. It can be just a little lift. Keeping both hips straight square to me. So watch we're not opening that top right hip. 12 seconds to go. Maybe sit down a little bit in this one-legged squat. Ah! You might be feeling both sides. This guy's stabilizing. You'll feel it too. Three, two, side step or hop to tippy toes. Or hop to hop. You can be doing press backs with your arms like I am, or you can do a volleyball block. Reach high, touch the ceiling. 6 seconds and we rest. Woo, three, two, rest. Oh, holy. Feeling hard today, I'm not gonna lie. I'm feeling it. 5 seconds, left leg lifting. Three, two, let's go, shoulders down. Exhale to lift. Hands can be on your body to cue your breath. Helps remind you to engage as we exhale and lift. Or you can have them hanging there. You can outstretch your branches for a little more balance challenge. Should we take a French toast break after this? What do you think? Everyone, French toast break? Yeah, I'm in. Ah, keep going. 12 seconds. Maybe keep it higher and just pulse. Maybe get lower in that right leg squat. Five, four, three. Let's go. Step, tippy toes, hop, volleyball block. Oh my goodness. 12 seconds to go. Maybe step or hop further or higher. Yes, five, four, three, two, rest. Oh boy. Half time. That was like a, I don't know what that was. You know what we're doing. Left leg in four. Left leg standing. Three, two, let's go. lift and lower. You're only doing it for 22 and a half seconds. So maybe get lower in this legged squat. Woo boy. 4, 3, 2, weight transfer to the right, switch. Trying not to lean over to that right side. Beautiful team. 10 seconds to go, then our final step, hop, hop, combo. 4, 3, 2, let's do it. You know you get a break after this. So give it to me. Yes. 15 seconds to go. Maybe go faster. 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. Oh boy. Seriously. Okay, moving on. This has been a lot of lower body. Okay, we're moving on to push-ups. Push up with a hip tap. So you can go on an incline while coffee table. You're gonna do one push up, nice wide feet. Hips stay as square as you can. Tap a hip, tap the other hip, push up. So the hips aren't twisting. Instead, I'd rather you really challenge your core, wide feet. Try to keep your hips still and touch. That's your first move. Second move, football fast feet. When I say when I say down, you reach down or maybe bend those knees a lot and touch down. I don't want to see this kind of rounding of the spine to get the hands towards each other down. Don't worry about it, just reach or touch with the bent knee. Okay, let's do a push-up. Decide where you want to go, wall, floor, somewhere in between. We go in 3, 2. Awesome. Feet almost as wide as a mat, a yoga mat would be. One push up, tap right hip, tap left hip. Trying to keep the hips still. Come back to the breath. Draw the hip bones together to stabilize as you tap. 25 seconds, 2, go. Elbows coming out and down to the side, like 45 degrees from the ribs. Keeping the neck long and looking down between your hands. We're not looking to our feet. You're close. 5, 4, 3, 2, fast feet. Let's go. This is too loud for neighbors below. Do any cardio instead. Okay, down. Reach your touch down. Come back in. Down, fast, fast, fast. Down, down, ah! Down, down, down. 3, 2, rest. Ooh, calves, yes. 12 seconds until we go again. Round 2 of 3, push up, tap, tap. Ready, 4, 3, 2, let's go. So you're exhaling as the hand taps the hip to find that engagement. Nice, Lisa. Beautiful, team. Hi, Liz. 25 to go here. Take a breather anytime. Down dog style, maybe a child's pose. Keeping that elbow a little bit soft of the hand. But it's not tapping your hip. My floor is very slippery. I keep slipping away. 5, 4, 3, 2, fast feet. Let's go. Ah, ready? Go. Go. Go as fast as you can. Maybe get a little lower. Go. Go. Ah, go. Go. 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. All right, 12 seconds. Line on, push up, tap, tap. Let's go. Five, three, two, let's do it. Last time you're doing this. Push up, tap, tap. If you're on the floor, you can always hit the knees when you start to fatigue. Twenty to go still. You can do it. Take your time. Never a need to rush through moves. 10 seconds to go, then our final fast beat. Ha! Five, four, three, two, let's go. Fast food. Ha! Go. Down, go, what did I say? I don't know. Down. Oh my gosh, down. 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 Four, three, two, rest. Oh my goodness. Okay. We got one more to do. After some water. We're gonna work some back. So your back move is gonna be in a prone position, meaning you're lying on your tummy. If you don't wanna lie on your tummy, you can do all of it either in a bent over kind of deadlift hip hinge or in a kneeling hip hinge. But if you're cool to be on your tummy, this is your move. Oh my gosh, my head's so out of breath. Okay, so your feet are almost as wide as your mat. Coming into core engagement. So even here, as you're exhaling, you're drawing the hip bones together and scooping out the belly so you find a little lift of the belly button off the ground, like a blueberry size, nothing big. Your arms are in a Y shape. You're gonna lift the arms, maybe the head and chest as well a little bit. Then from here, while you're still lifted, you bring the arms down to a T position, and then you lower. Then you lift in the T, sweep them overhead to the Y, and then lower. That's your back strength position, strength move. From there, we're going into a snow angel burpee. Eek. So you're gonna be either in a down dog or a plank. Your step or hop forward, sweep the arms like a snow angel, sweep them back down, squat down, place the hands back to a down dog or a plank. So it's a burpee, but it's a low impact burpee. You can hop if you want. Super intense though without the hop, you do not need it. Okay, let's go. Meet me wherever you're going to be for this back work. Palms are gonna face the ground. You're on the ground, legs almost as wide as the mat. And I want you to find length in those legs. So point the toes, strength up into the glutes. When you are ready, timer is on. Draw the shoulders down, lift into a Y, hands come slowly down to a T, and then we lower. Then we lift in the T, take it to the Y, and lower. Go slow. Think about those back and shoulder muscles working here to create the lift and the movement of the arms and shoulders. If you want to lift your legs, by all means, go for it. As long as your back is okay with it, you can float those legs an inch off the ground, still finding that strength. Imagine someone's pulling the legs away from your body. Five, four, three, two, into our snow angel burpee. Down dog or plank, step or hop forward, sweep those arms out to the side and back down. If you are stepping your feet, can you switch your stepping foot, your lead stepping foot each time? Five, four, three, two, rest. 15, two to go. We go in 10. Have a lie or come to your hip hinge position. Three, two, and one. Let's go. Lift to the T. Lower. Doesn't need to be a high lift. Can be just a little wee lift. If it's too much today, you can always place your hands under your shoulders and just do a little baby cobra using the weight of your hands for some support. 20 seconds here, still to go. Oh boy. We have 8, 4, 3, 2, 1. Snow angel burpees. Let's go. Step or hop, down dog or plank. And as always, if you just hate this move completely, do any cardio. You do not have to do what I'm doing. 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. One more to go. Ready for it? We go in 6, 3, 2, let's go. Slow, controlled. Oh, goodness. Nice job, team. 30 seconds to go. Length through those fingers in the T and the Y. Open the fingers, reach through them. You got 12 left. Final snow angel burpees coming up. I don't know why I call them snow angels. Angel burpees works just fine. 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. The Alberta in me. I think snow angels. Keep it up. Maybe pick up the tempo. You only have 15 seconds left. Five, three, two, rest. Whew, grab some water. Holy Dinah. Okay, walk it out a little bit. Just bringing the heart rate down. Maybe shake out the legs, the shoulders, the wrists. Take a couple big breaths, maybe some horsey breaths. Start to swing the arms. You can open and close or forward and really kind of release the wrists. Okay. You can keep walking or you can come to stillness for a little shoulder stretch. Other side. We'll do a standing stretch and then we can find our mats for Lisa's breath work. All right. Feet are hip width distance. Whew, shake it out. And then grab the right shoe, quad stretch. Nice job today. So next week, I don't know if I'm going to do a class. It's Easter long. I feel like people might not be that keen, so stay tuned. Take that right heel forward, bend the left knee, toe to nose. April 11th, though, we are doing boot camp to benefit from back. Nope. Big sisters. Another B. Big sisters on April 11th. One of my faves. Stand up, bring that right leg back behind you, come up onto the back toes, little bit of a lunge, and then tuck the pelvis, pubic bone to belly button, so you're feeling hip flexor on this right side. You can stay here or add a little side body stretch. That right arm reaches overhead, still tucking, still finding that hip flexor length. Awesome. Stand tall and then drive that right heel into the ground. It might not touch the ground. That's fine. Just energetically drive the heel away from you so you're feeling back of that right leg. Awesome. Step the right foot forward. Let's do it all on the left. Quad. Whew. Maybe those four glasses of Passover wine is why I'm feeling like it's so hard today. Could be.
Okie dokie.
Step that right foot back, come up onto the hip flexor. Did I forget one? Oh, I did. Sorry, toe to nose. It's also maybe killed a few brain cells. Forgetting what I'm doing. Stand and then take it back behind you on the left toes. Tuck pubic bone to belly button. If you're feeling stable, you don't want to add any more, don't. But if you're going there with me, left arm overhead, draw those shoulders down, lift up through that left hip. Awesome. Bring that arm back to center. Drive down through that left heel. Stand tall on nice soft knees. Interlace the hands behind the back of the tail, behind the tailbone. And then drive the hands down. A little bit of a heart opener. You can also release the hands and just reach them back behind you. You can also lift the hands up off your tailbone, depending on how you're feeling today. And let's reverse it. Interlace the hands in front of the chest. Little rounding of the spine, keeping the shoulders pulled down. Scooping out the belly. Awesome. Okay, Lisa. It's all you, sister. Where do you want us?
All right. Sorry, I had to get down. You can take yourself to a comfortable position. I was like lying down, but if you want to sit, you can continue sitting in a comfortable position where you feel like your back is supported and all that. What we're going to do today is we're going to do a bit of a gratitude meditation. I want you to just sit here or lie there, put one hand to your chest, one hand to your stomach, and just take a few deep breaths. See if you can just notice your chest rise and fall with each inhalation and exhalation. When you're ready, you can let your eyes drift closed. As we continue breathing, see if you can start to deepen the breath. Perhaps pushing into the diaphragm and opening up the stomach. Just bringing your attention to your breath. As your body rests, just notice the breath deepen, but without making too much effort at the same time. With each exhale, see if you can let go of any tension. See if you can relax your face, your shoulders, your belly, your legs. Maybe release your jaw, slack on the jaw. On your next exhale, see if you can settle your attention to the area around your heart. So you place a hand to the heart. See if you can notice and focus on feelings of love, compassion, empathy, or forgiveness. See if you can connect to those feelings. and sensations in your heart. With your attention on your heart center, bring to mind something or someone you're grateful for. And as you continue with your easy, relaxed breathing, perhaps you feel gratitude for being alive or healthy. Perhaps you're grateful for the abundance of nature that produces the food to nourish your body, the water you drink, the air you breathe, the places you play. Now bring your attention to people who truly nourish you in your life and how they bless you with their presence. Even if they're far away or nearby, take a moment to just notice those people or person. With your next breath, bring your attention to gratitude for your own life, to your unique talents, skills, and gifts. And bring your attention to how this gratitude feels in the area around your heart. With each inhale, let this feeling grow outwards. See if you can notice it expanding to fill your chest, your arms, your hands, through your legs and your feet. With each inhale, this feeling grows, filling you up. And now, even as you return your attention to your breath, let your body remember the sensations of your gratitude. And during the day or over the next week, you can even put a hand to the heart and remind yourself of what you focused on in today's practice. Start to open your eyes, move your toes, wiggle your feet and your fingers. Open your eyes. Thank yourself for spending the last few minutes doing your gratitude practice. And thank you, Shana and Swan, for all the work you do.
Thank you, Lisa. I have so much gratitude for you for doing this with me for a year.
Yeah,
thank you for continuing to join us and help us through these times, really, truly.
Thank you. It helps me too.
My pleasure. Thanks all for coming. Happy Passover for those of you celebrating. Happy Easter next weekend for those of you celebrating. And I don't know about next weekend. We'll see. But April 11th for sure for our big sisters. If you're donating directly to SWAN, if you want to, go for it and let me know. And if you want to send it through me, go for it. And I will donate as a collective. Bye, Sarah.
Thank you, Shane.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.